So that should be enough. If I click the play button, it make an audio stream player play the audio stream that it has. So you can see here, if I'm in the full screen, you can see I'm going to open our player script, and I'm going to make that take up the full screen. So the very quick and easy way to create an at-on-ready variable declaration, my script, and I'm going to make that take up the full screen. Box on the side visible. I am going to find the variable I want to add as an on-ready variable on the left. I'm going to hold the control key and I'm going to drag that node. Into my script. If I let it go there, you'll see it's created a whole at-on-ready declaration for that variable. So you can see here, if I'm in that full screen, it has added the at-on-ready annotation because it knows that this variable needs to wait until the ready function is called. It's given it a node name based on the name we gave the audio stream player when we renamed it. It gave it the right default type, and it gave us the path to that explosion audio variable. And now we have access to this variable. We can use this explosion audio variable name to call its methods and functions. So let's do that. The way we can make an audio stream player play the audio stream that it has is with a function called play. So I'm going to go